Can a container control the router? Somebody asked us if they can make use of RouterOS features from within a container, and the immediate answer I wanted to give was no, because the whole idea of containers is to create these little sandboxed environments where even if you horribly mess up, you will not destroy your whole system. But the reality is that if you really need your container to control your router, then you can make that happen. I will show you how, and I will give you a couple of tips on best practice. When you create a container in RouterOS, it can communicate with your router through IP, which means that all the methods for remotely managing your device over IP are available to the container. You could use Telnet with the help of little bash scripts. You could use SSH. It allows to connect and execute commands with simple one-liners, so that is pretty convenient. If you want to make use of that method, you can watch my video on SSH for automation. But then you could also use one of our APIs. Believe it or not, we got two of those. Both can provide encryption, but in this case, you probably don't care about that, as your communication will not be leaving the router. So we have the regular or old school API that can be very good, but it requires some coding and understanding of sockets. And then we have REST API that is much more simple to use. It works through HTTP requests and returns simple text in JSON format, which makes the output easy to parse in your scripts, and it is still human readable. It is basically just like a shopping list with items and their values. We have a video on using REST API, and we also have explained it in our documentation, so I won't get into detail on how REST API works. To make use of it, we just need some way to make HTTP requests. There are many tools that can do it. You could use your web browser if you want to just play around, but for the purpose of scripting, you probably want to use a Linux command line tool like curl or wget. Or if you are doing a Python script, of course, there are Python libraries for that as well. I would just use curl in this case. So first we're going to need a container that has our tool of choice installed. You can build a container from scratch that is perfectly tailored to your needs, but in this case I would just use a generic Alpine container that I have added from a remote image. Currently it is just running a loop, so I can shell into it. There are a bunch of tools that come pre-installed, and we do have wget here already. But unfortunately, we cannot use it because it is not the full version of wget. It does not have an option to pass login credentials to the HTTP server. And for obvious security reasons, RouterOS requires user login credentials before it will execute any commands through REST API. Therefore, I would just install curl. It is probably the better tool anyway. Once we have it, I can make my first API call. I will just issue curl u admin column for user admin and no password, then 172.17.0.1, which is the gateway address for my VEETH interface. Follow that up with /rest/, and then some command that we can execute. I immediately get a block of text that is the JSON response from RouterOS, so it is working. Now I use the default get method, which for the API is equivalent to print, and I got the results from the interface WireGuard section. Of course, we could also use the other HTTP request methods to execute other types of actions, and we will do that in a second. This brings me to a potential use case. Let's say you want a tunnel going to your container. Well then, instead of installing WireGuard or some other tunnel client inside the container, it would be more efficient to just use the RouterOS built-in features and then route the traffic to the container. Maybe our container needs to connect through a tunnel based on some trigger or a schedule. Then it should have the option to enable and disable it. So to disable this WireGuard interface, I could use the following curl command. It starts off the same as before, but I want to use the X option followed by patch. Then I can enter my IP and /rest/interface /wireguard But now we also add /*F because that is the ID of my interface as I learned from the previous GET request. But then we also have to specify what exact action we want to take. And we can do that by adding data in JSON format. Inside it, we have to specify the parameter that we want to change, in this case, disabled, and its new value is going to be true. Finally, add a header saying the content type is application JSON. As you can see, I got a response and I have successfully disabled the interface. And we can double confirm that in the WireGuard section. This is all great, but we did this by logging in as a user with full rights. That is not a good idea. Here is a better approach. First, let's make sure that our admin has a secure password that nobody knows. It would be even better if we used an uncommon username instead of admin, but that's up to you. The important part is that we are not going to use the administrator privileges inside containers. We will create another user that only has read privileges. I will name it container and give it a password. Then I can go to the script section and add a new one that will allow our containers to execute very specific actions in RouterOS. I will name this one wg-enable and I will add the don't require permissions equals yes property. We need it if we want our read-only user to be able to execute this script. Then we can edit the source. Here I can enter any RouterOS commands just like we would in CLI. So I will add a WireGuard enable command using the same unique identifier as before. And I will also add a log entry that will simply record for us that the container enabled WireGuard. Now we are all set. Let's run our new script from the container. First, I just need to get the ID of my script. So I will make a GET request with the new user credentials. And then I can make a POST request for the system script run command with data that contains the ID of our script. We get an empty response, but if we look at our WireGuard interface, it is running and there is an info message in the logs. That is how you can allow your containers to execute very specific actions in RouterOS without throwing security out of the window. Thanks for watching.